Welcome to Chemistry Revision on the Move, Acid-Base Equilibria. Now, as this is a revision program, what you need to do is to make sure that you can anticipate what's going to happen in each of the slides. So, here we go. Let's start. So, let's start with some basic definitions. Remember that acids and bases can be defined in two ways, Lewis acid base theory and Bronsted-Lowry acid-base theory. Here we're looking at the Bronsted-Lowry definition. So an acid is a proton donor and a base is a proton acceptor. So let's have a look at some examples of these. So if we take an acid such as ethanoic acid, the base, the proton acceptor of that will be the ethanoate ion, and these are known as a conjugate acid-base pair. Ethanoic acid can donate a proton and the ethanoate ion can accept a proton. You can also have acids and bases the other way around. So for example, an ammonium ion can be considered to be an acid. It can donate a proton. And of course the conjugate base of the ammonium ion is ammonia. Again, these can be known as a conjugate acid base pair. In this particular case, the ammonia is the base and the ammonium ion is the acid. Other basic definitions, let's take water. Now, of course, water can act as both an acid and a base, proton donor and a proton acceptor. And here's an equation that we can use to show that. Quite often what you will find is that we can simplify this to this equilibrium like that. Now the concentration of water is 55.555 molar recurring, and what we'll find is that the position of this equilibrium is well over to the left hand side. So therefore the concentration of water remains essentially constant. So when we define Kw, we can ignore the concentration of water, or at least put it as a constant, and we get a Kw expression where Kw is equal to the product of the concentrations of hydrogen ions and hydroxide ions and equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 14 at least at 298 Kelvin. So this is sometimes known as the ionic product of water, or the dissociation constant for water, or just Kw. It's constant at constant temperature. But of course, if you change the temperature, the value of Kw will increase or decrease. Have a think about how it might change with changing temperature.